Hey guys, welcome to the Liberal Hivemind, a channel solely focused on exposing the abundant hypocrisy of the left. Everywhere they go, they get heckled. And of course, they, I mean Democrats, but in this specific scenario, I mean race-grifting Democrats. And of course, who do you think we're referencing here? None other than Mr. Al Sharpton himself, who seems to show up each and every single time he could take advantage of the news cycle. In this case, take advantage of a completely false narrative and put himself in the spotlight. Well, like I always say, folks, that stuff don't fly in Texas. He got booed and heckled, protesters lobbed hilarious questions at him, and the best part of all is the people who were going after him didn't exactly fit the description of the right-wing white male boogeyman, but rather, they were Texas Latinos. And so let's get into this, folks. As Democrats continue to face backlash and are being heckled everywhere they go, but before we get into any of it, please make sure to leave a like, a comment, subscribe, share the video as much as possible. We're still shadow banned by the YouTube algorithm. Them hidden from non-subscribed viewers, and with that out of the way, let's roll the tape. Alright folks, so take a look at this. Watch, Al Sharpton heckled during tour of Haitian migrant camp in Del Rio, Texas. How much money are you making out of this? Someone in the crowd asked Sharpton.
Kids are being sedated at the U.S. border. Why are you not being a voice for the children?
From Atlanta, Georgia, New Birth Baptist Church. Reverend Freddie Haynes,
why are you still being racist and where it doesn't exist?
Why are you trying to come and promote violence? Why are you here advocating for violence? Why are you here advocating for violence? Del Rio is not a racist city. Del Rio is a loving, caring community. We don't want your racism in Texas. Get out of here. Nobody wants to hear your racist nonsense in Del Rio.
Sheriff,
Get out of the Trump supporters. And we will continue to come back over and over again. For people to be treated like this in a humane way, and for people to feel that they can use weaponization of horses to treat human beings should be resisted. So they can have all the hecklers they want. They should do all they can. We will keep coming back as long as it's necessary. We want to see the border patrol fully investigated. We want those that were involved to face justice. And we want to see full asylum rights given to those that deserve it, like anyone else in this country that enters this country. We cannot.
Democrats cannot go anywhere. They cannot show their faces without meeting protests from patriotic Americans. And you notice just how disingenuous this whole thing is? All of a sudden, Democrats are pretending to care about what's going on at the southern border. Democrats caused this, and then they're taking a literal hoax, a fabrication of reality. This idea that Border Patrol agents were whipping migrants, which the video evidence itself does not confirm, but Democrats are all on this due to the racial optics of it, to try to get a moral victory. They didn't want to show their faces at the border. They didn't even want to talk about the border. They didn't want to take any questions about the border until this phony story from Axios was pushed on Twitter, and all of a sudden, their eyes opened up as big as possible. Eyes on the prize, so to speak. A racial narrative looking to be taken advantage of by the Democrat establishment, and they are all on it. All of a sudden, it's not about the Biden border crisis that he literally caused, and their policies led to everything we're seeing. It's those evil Border Patrol agents and the evil southern states. And most likely somehow Trump's fault and a remnant of Trump's policies, the Democrats are here once again to invoke the past, push another hoax, and create more division. Those people will pay. Joe Biden flees podium after threatening Border Patrol agents on horseback for doing their job.
Given what we saw at the border this week, have you failed in that promise? And this is happening under your watch. Do you take responsibility for the chaos that's unfolding?
Of course I take responsibility. I'm president, but it was horrible what to see, as you saw. To see people treated like they did, horses barely running them over, people being strapped, it's outrageous. I promise you, those people will pay. They will be an investigation underway now, and there will be consequences. There will be consequences.
Again, these Border Patrol agents were literally doing by the book what policy dictated. Nobody was injured. There were no whips, just horse reins. They were used as a deterrence mechanism to keep people away from their horses. But now Joe Biden sees an opportunity to throw Border Patrol agents under the bus. People are probably going to lose their job. A massive fiasco is going to happen. And it's all going to serve as a distraction for the Democrats away from the crisis that they have caused and that Border Patrol agents are trying to control. I mean, it sounds evil, it sounds despicable, but I am not kidding when I tell you that Democrats are happy this is happening. At first, it was looking like it was going to be a massive disaster for them, and it really was for maybe half a second, but the moment the Democrats realized that they could take advantage of this, that they could somehow perpetuate this hoax regardless of all the fact-checking that's come out since, and then seem like decisive leaders, social justice activists, swooping in the end and fixing it, well, that's the moment the strategy changed, and you can tell there is near jubilation with one specific individual who can never seem to hide how she truly feels or to act normal whenever it comes to human emotions. Take a look at this. Weird. Kamala Harris giggles comparing phony U.S. Border Patrol agents on horse to times of slavery.
First of all, I've been very clear about the images that you and I both saw of those law enforcement officials on horses. I was outraged by it. It was horrible and deeply troubling. There's been now an investigation that is being conducted, which I fully support, and there needs to be consequence and accountability. The human beings should not be treated that way, and as we all know, it also evoked images of some of the worst moments of our history, where that kind of behavior has been used against the indigenous people of our country, has been used against African Americans during...
Why is she laughing? She's talking about atrocities of the past, making a direct comparison as if this completely exaggerated story from the southern border is somehow connected or within the same realm whatsoever. I mean, that hypocrisy is one thing, but to then show up on TV and perpetuate this false story and false narrative, condemning border agents who are just trying to protect the country to the extent of making comparisons to slave owners and human rights abusers, and to do it while laughing is so incredibly despicable, divisive, socially destructive, and it's exactly what the Democrats do and are best at. That's why she's happy. That's why she's laughing and smiling, thinking we got exactly what we needed to turn this whole thing around and look like the good guys in the end. It's disgusting. Democrats all of a sudden seem to care about the suffering at the southern border, suffering that they've enabled and they've created, suffering that's been going on at a near historic rate over the last 8 to 9 months of Joe Biden's presidency. Suffering which they have not addressed even for a second. Graphic. Mexican cops pull drowned migrant's body from Texas border river. The amount of people who have lost their lives, people who have drowned, people who have been abused, especially on the lower age spectrum. I'm trying to say that in a specific way where I'm not going to flag the algorithm. But considering the mass suffering that's been going on at the southern border for months now, which the Democrats have largely ignored, and of course enabled and exacerbated, all of a sudden they seem to care. Because now it's politically expedient and now they see an opportunity that they could take advantage of. If they think we're buying it, then they have another thing coming. More and more people are waking up to the constant racial grift. Any and every single time the Democrats can paint America as bad or racist or irredeemable and paint themselves as the heroes, they take it, regardless of whatever corpses they're standing on. And this is why they're receiving backlash. People are done. This is why they're dropping in support with minority communities. Latinos in southern border states understand the devastation, and they're clearly able to see that Democrats are the ones who caused all of this entire mess, and to see Democrats clearly trying to take advantage of it, it's not going to work. And honestly, these days it seems as though nothing's really working for Democrats now, is it? The initial topic of this video being Democrats getting heckled everywhere they go, let's finish off with, once again, another one. Susie1776 from Twitter writes, "They won't be able to walk down the street. Hillary being booed and called a criminal over and over again outside Queen's University." It is the age of the internet, the age of independent content creators, the age of independent thought and individual research, at least to a certain extent. The grifts no longer work. Politicians' control over messaging is slowly slipping away. The shiny veneer has washed off, and people see them for what they truly are. It's only a matter of time before too many people have taken the red pill, and it's over for the Democrats. At least, a man can hope. That's what I got for you guys, though. If you enjoyed the video, please make sure to leave a like, a comment, subscribe, share the video as much as possible. We're still shadow banned by the YouTube algorithm. I gotta get back to work, though. I wanna thank you for watching. I'll see you on the next one.